Tip number one, divide your total residency time in blocks of 6 months each in it. You could do this on a notepad, paper, and in your mind. We will be using this to reference all through this video. I'm going to use a 3-year residency as an example. If your residency is 4 years or longer, like in Canada and other countries, then you could still do the same. Just keep on adding those blocks of 6 months each. Tip number two, pick the right book. What you need is a book that covers all the basics and subspecialties at this stage. The goal is not just to pass your exams, but to build your knowledge. You need to know as a physician what you should do, how you should be doing, and why you do what you do. I have left a list of books and links in the description below. Here are my top recommendations. Now, all residency program talks about Miller's anesthesia. I would say this is definite buy. But can you read this from page to page all through the book? This might be practically difficult. This is a very good book to have it with you in case you need to reference anything. The other book I have is Morgan's Clinical Anesthesiology. This is an excellent book that provides a summary of all important topics. So this is again a definite buy. There are two other books. Now these books you would need when you're actually reading about cases, which I will talk about a little later in the video. The first book is Stolting's Anesthesia and Coexisting Diseases. The other book is Yao and Ortuzio's Problem-Oriented Management. Now, when it comes to equipments, where you would have to know things like anesthesia workstation, vaporizers, the different laryngoscopes, airways, and all other things related to anesthesia equipment, the book I recommend is this, Anesthesia Equipment Principles and Applications. So this is written by Jan Ehrenworth and James Eisenkraft along with James Berry. I have written a chapter in this book. I don't say it because of that. I have read parts of this book and this is an excellent book for equipment. So this I would say is a definite buy. You want to keep it with you. Now there are other textbooks that you may need. So one is Physics. So this is an excellent book to know all about physics. The other is Stolting's Physiology and Pharmacology. So these books, either you can decide to buy or you can reference them in the library. There are also many subspecialty books you probably don't need at this stage, but if you're really interested, you can check them out in your library. And if you like any of them, feel free to buy them. Now, tip number three, let's go back to the timeline. The first 6 months is very exciting. And during this time, you focus on physics, physiology, and pharmacology. Read about all the gas laws. Well, you might be thinking, how is that relevant to my practice? Think of a tall building and the amount of foundation it needs. You're exactly similar to that. You need a solid foundation to become an outstanding anesthesiologist or anesthetist. So the stronger the foundation is, the longer you will go. This will not only help you ace your exams, this would help you manage cases in a very safe and comfortable way. This will help you know not only what to do, but also know what not to do, which is a very critical part of decision making. Now, as you're reading physics, physiology, pharmacology, you're getting oriented to the basics of anesthesia working in the operating room or operation theater, like induction, maintenance, emergence, fluid management, intubating skills, placing IV, and other things. If you find time with all this, I would say history of anesthesia is another really exciting thing that I personally love to see how our specialty evolved. This is an excellent book from Wood's Library of Anesthesiology, but you can always reference this in your library. Moving on to tip number four. You would have started rotating through subspecialties. You're probably 6 months or a year into your anesthesia residency, where you start seeing cases related to pediatric, cardiac, obstetric, and many others. So when you're actually going through these subspecialties, now pick your book. That could be Morgan, that could be Miller. Read all the basics related to that subspecialty. For example, if you're doing pediatric anesthesia rotation, make sure you read about physiology, pharmacology, the anatomical differences, differences in airway, how to intubate, all that during this rotation. Tip number five, read about cases. You'll be assigned to an operating room or theater, and you would typically know your cases the previous day. So read about these cases. For example, if you're doing a pediatric anesthesia rotation, and your case is inguinal hernia. Now read about how anesthesia is done in a child for inguinal hernia. Read about ilioinguinal, iliohypogastric nerve block in a child. Or let's say you're doing a thoracotomy. Read about how to do one lung ventilation in a child. Now, this reading can actually come from Miller, Morgan, or also from subspecialty books. Now, this is a personal choice if you want to invest in subspecialty books at this stage or use your library or friends to read this. I would be okay if you don't want to buy these at this stage. Now, you can also read these cases from review articles in journals like Anesthesiology, Anesthesia Analgesia, the American Society of Anesthesiology, and also many other subspecialty websites. A journal that I highly recommend is Indian Journal of Anesthesia. They provide phenomenal educational reviews related to clinical topics. Those are really well written and well researched into when people are writing those articles. So take a look at Indian Journal of Anesthesia. On to tip number 6. Make a list of all the questions as you're reading your basics, reading about your cases. Put it on a notepad or wherever you want it to discuss with your faculty anesthesiologist or anesthetist when you work with them. So get everything clarified. Now, this will help not only your knowledge solidify, stay in your long-term memory box, but when you actually do a case 5-10 years down the lane, you will still remember like it was yesterday. Let's get back to the timeline. Now, you may have exams every 6 months, or you may have it once every 2 years. Now, this is when you dedicate your last few months for your anesthesia boards or anesthesia exams. If you have an MCQ-based exam, you can read about MCQs from any dedicated resource. But if you have a theory-based exam, either ways, by now, you would have read all the theory, you would have read about the cases, so your knowledge is so solidified that you're going to ace the exam. And also remember how to manage cases for life. Tip number 8, plan your week on a Sunday as to what you need to read through during the week. Make sure you bring some materials to the operating room or operation theater. You never know, there may be some downtime, there may be some case cancellations. You don't want to scramble what I am going to do, so be well prepared for all those unexpected situations. And if you have a stable case, you may also have some time to skim through a few of those. Tip number 9, read most days of the week. Now, I'm not saying every day because practically this may not be possible. You may be on call, you may have other commitments, but make sure you read at least most days of the week, evenings, nights, daytime, whenever it works for you, make use of the time. Now, tip number 10, form a study group. Now, you're not competing with your other residents, but you're actually learning mutually. So form a group, discuss things amongst each other. If you have any tough questions, bring it to your supervisor, bring it to your faculty, anesthesiologist, anesthetist, your mentor, whoever it is who can help you answer those. This discussion helps retain everything in long-term memory, clarifies the concept, which is so crucial. Now, tip number 11, when you're working in the operation theater, make sure you actively seek feedback to improvise upon yourself. You may get tips on how to manage the blood pressure, how to intubate, how to place the IV better. So actively seek out for feedbacks so you can really improvise upon your skills, your knowledge, and build a solid foundation. Tip number 12, which is the last, it is easy to ignore, but take care of yourself. Get some good rest, get some sleep. Some days you have less sleep. That's just the nature of the things. Make sure you have adequate hydration. Make sure you take care of your health, your well-being. If you know of any other books, just leave it in the comments below. Now, if you're wondering how pediatric anesthesia is done, how is anesthesia induced in a one-year-old child? How is the intubation performed? Check this video out from this link to see that. Take care, stay safe. I'll talk to you soon.